it might be that your media library has come to look a little bit like this. Very cluttered with a lot of images that you don't even know if they're still being used on your website. But also in the back end of your hosting company, you might be surprised at how big this website actually has become. I need to have a program that can help us deleting images that are not used on the front end of our website. That would be the best case. Luckily for us, there is such a tool. To get the tool, we go to wp.discount/media-cleaner. This link is also in the description of this video and in the comments. Press enter. And then we are at the website of this cute kitten, Meow Apps, and they do have a couple of interesting tools, like this Media Cleaner Pro. I'm first going to use the free version over there, and then we're going to try the pro version, and I'm going to show you what the difference is and if it works for our problem in this website. So to get the free version, we click over here on free. There we go. And we're just going to press on download. There we are. Log in to your WordPress website. If you're still logging in using WP Admin,
no!
Nope.
No!
That's not a very safe way, so please watch my security tutorial over here and I'll show you everything about how to secure your WordPress website once and for all. Then we go over here to plugins and we're going to add new plugin. Press on upload plugin and select the file the Media Cleaner in our downloads folder. Press open and then we press install now. Activate plugin. And then we are here at the plugin list. Before we continue, make sure that you have deactivated any caching plugin, especially when they're using lazy loading for images, on your website. So we go to WP Rocket and I'm going to press on deactivate, no deactivate, and press confirm. Here we go. We can, of course, enable it again once we have finished our work. Let's go to media and then we go to cleaner over there. Click on it. Then we see an important message. Make sure that you have a backup in place of your entire database and all your media files. Go to your hosting company. Now this website is hosted on SiteGround and as you can see, we have a daily backup. Every single day I can restore this entire website with no problem at all. But if you are still doubtful or you don't trust this backup, check out this tutorial and I'll show you exactly how to set up a staging environment in just 3 to 4 minutes. It's really quick and then you can experiment with this Media Cleaner plugin on this staging environment. Should be good. Once you're sure you have a good backup in place, then we're going to click on this scan button. Now let the plugin do its work. It's going to scan your media library and it's going to compare it with the active pages on your website. Just let it go. The scan has been completed and as you can see, there are 3,080 issues with our files, accounting for almost 5 GB. That's a lot. If you only have 200 or 300 issues, you can scroll down and you can see all these images manually, check them out manually to see if they are truly not in use. But if you have a very big website like this one with 3,080 issues, I don't know if all these images are not being used. If you're absolutely sure that these images are not being used on your website, you can select them manually and press on delete 3 entries. Now they are not being deleted immediately. There is a step in between. The creators of this plugin are actually genius. I mean, if you delete them and they disappear on the front end, there is no way to get them back if you truly delete them. But no, they are being moved to a trash folder. And you can always restore them from there without any issues. So in our case, I'm just going to delete all of them. 3,080 files. Just press on delete all. Here we go. Press OK. Don't worry. It won't be deleted immediately. It's being placed in a different kind of folder. So I'm curious how my website looks after deleting all the images. Now we have moved everything to the trash in here. 3,080 files are in the trash. The next step is to see if our website still works. We're going to visit our website and we're going to open the link in a new incognito screen or private window. This doesn't look very good. If we scroll down, we can see that every image, oh, one is still there. This doesn't look very good. This one is also still here. All these images are missing. This doesn't look very good. Let's see one apartment. These images are still here. But those are gone. This one is still here. The slider still works. Great. All these images are gone. These ones still work. These images are all gone. These are still gone. All right. So we got a bit of a problem. A lot of images are not here. Now, if you're only missing one or two images, you can easily fix this without buying the pro version. You can just right click on it, press on inspect. Here we go. Then we got the Google development tools. And you'll see over here this error. If you click on this one, and we can see all these errors, failed to load resources 404. It means the image is gone. What you can do is just right click on this, press copy link address over there. Then we go back to the media cleaner and we paste in over here. We're going to paste in this link and we're going to remove this entire URL and like this. So we only have the file name of the image. Press enter. And then we can see over here, these are the images that has the same name. So we're going to select them all and we press recover three items. There we are. And this is the way how you can recover 3, 4, 5, 6, 10 images on your entire website, if that is the case for you. If you only have 100 images on your entire website and you remove them and your website still looks great, then you're done. I don't think it's a good solution to fix all my 3,000 images going the manual way. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to buy the pro version so you can see how that works. But before I do that, I'm going to restore all the images. So just press this cross icon and then we press over here, recover all. And when I press this button, we will recover all these images back from this folder to the uploads folder and all should be good. All my files have been restored. Let's check if the website works. Now this is the way it's supposed to look. All the images are back in place and everything works exactly like it should. All right, let's try the pro version. Let me see what this pro version actually is. You can see in the pro version, we have a file system scan and also handle more plugins, including page builders. This website is built with the Divi page builder, so that just might be the issue. Now let's go up to the licenses over there. We have yearly licenses for one website, 5 or 20, and lifetime licenses for 5, 2500, and 2500. You know me, I always love lifetime licenses, but I don't know how many websites you have, what your budget is, etc. So I'm going with the lifetime license for 5 websites because only 5 of my clients have this gigantic websites. So I'm going to press on purchase. Then we're going to select our payment method, credit card or PayPal. And then we fill in all our information. And after that, I'm going to click on purchase. Well done. Now we can just download the Media Cleaner Pro by clicking on this. And make sure to copy your license key over there. Copy it. Before we install the pro version, we have to deactivate and delete the free version. So press on deactivate. And then we press on delete. Okay. Then we press on add new plugin, upload plugin, and select the profile we've just downloaded. Well, the names are actually the same. We're going to use the newest version. Press open and press install now. There we are, activate plugin. Now we need to activate our license or else we don't have the pro features. So we go to settings over there. Then we go to license in here. And we're going to paste it in there. There we are and press validate license. Thank you, the pro features has been enabled. Press reload. Here we are, and then we go to the media library scan. Now, this time you can also do a live content scan. It slows down the speed dramatically and is only useful if you have a lot of people going through your website right now. No need for that now, maybe later on, but for now, we're not gonna do this. Then we can filter it, enable only images, nothing else will be scanned. And you can also check these extra rules to consider as in use. It means if you've ever uploaded the image to a blog post or a page, it will be filtered out by this cleaner tool. We're not gonna do that right now. Let's go to file system scan. I also wanna check the content, post pages and other post type metadata widgets exactly. And you can also choose to filter by the thumbnails only because normally every image you upload will be generated thumbnails 3 times. That's why your media library gets really big. Let's go to advanced. You can hide thumbnails, you can skip the trash, hide the warning message. I have read it, so yes, let's hide it. We have also the expert mode. And all these things are actually great as they are. So let's start a scan again. Go to media, go to cleaner. Then we're going to scan the entire media library. Again, we have 3080 issues, almost 5 GB. So let's see if the pro scan is different than the normal scan. All right, the results are in, and hey, this is very different. Now we have only found 1016 issues with our files, and those are 2.3 GB. It's still a lot, but I get my hopes up that this is actually working the way it's intended. So what are we going to do? We're going to delete everything. Here we go. Press OK. Again, it's going to move all these files to a different folder, and we can check our website if everything still works. But saving 2.3 GB is actually quite a lot. All right, now we have 1016 files in the trash, no issues found. Now, I'm very curious. Let's open it up in a new incognito screen and see what happens. I can see, hey, the logo is missing. Not that important. Well, we can fix that easily. If the rest is all okay, it's just one file. I can live with that. Scroll down. Everything looks really great. Everything is basically the same. Let's see if the reviews, they all work. Wow, all right, that looks great. Let's go to one of the apartments. In here, a few details. Here we go. Everything works. We have the slider. We have all the images over there. I'm pretty impressed. So the only thing is the logo is not working. So I right click on it, inspect, I go to errors, and I can see only this one is by accident deleted. So I'm gonna right click on it and press copy link address. I go into my website, to the trash. I'm gonna search for this one, paste it in and delete everything except for the file name. Press enter. Just going to recover these three entries. There we go. Now let's see how it works right now. And here we are. I have a beautiful website and everything works like it should. We have the slider images. We have all these images. Excellent. Now make sure to go through all the pages of your website to see if all your images are still there. For example, this file is not doing anything. So again, going to inspect it, go to my errors, and I can see that this video has also been by accident deleted. Right click, clean this one, and search again for the other file. It's a video. Let's do all files called video. Let's see, we only have one. Gonna recover this entry. There we are. And we can see that this video works again the way it should. If you are absolutely sure that all the images on your entire website are working and the plugin didn't make any mistakes, you still have the backup. So don't worry, if things go south, you always can back and refer to the backup you have in place. Then we can go over here and we can empty the entire trash. Still worried and you think, well, is that a safe thing to do right now? I'm not completely sure. There's another layer of security we can build in. Go to the hosting company of this website, go to file manager, we go to public HTML, WP content, and then we go to the uploads folder, and then we can see that there is a folder in here called WordPress Media Cleaner Trash. Click on this one, and then we're just going to download it all. How to do that? Well, you cannot click on download in here within SiteGround. Every host is basically the same, so we're gonna press on archive over there, trashed. Media library files. And I'm just gonna press on confirm. Here we go. And what my hosting company is going to do is going to create a zip file. We can download it to our computer just to be safe. It will save us a bunch of space on our hosting company. And we can always unzip that file back again, right to here, go to media cleaner and restore the trash, and all is good. If you have any questions or you want to share your experience with your files, drop them down in the comments. I always read them and I love them. And I hope to see you in this video, which is also an awesome video, I'm sure.